cold and fog was as thick as pea soup on that Christmas Eve of 1843, when Scrooge walked through the busy streets of London to his counting house. With his business partner Marley long gone, 7 years to this day in fact, his clerk was busy working, waiting for the arrival of Scrooge.
Keeping busy, Cratchit?
Yes, as always, sir.
Good. Glad to hear it. It's what I pay you for, isn't it, Cratchit?
Yes, sir.
We'll see to it, then.
Yes, sir. It's a lady, sir. She's here for you and Marley.
Ha, Marley. He's been dead for 7 years this day.
heard, but the carol singers outside were causing his dread.
Oh, that dreaded sound.
Oh, no. Not again. Who are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas present.
Why are you here?
Yes, who's here and now? Will you take a walk with me this Christmas Eve?
Yes, but no more flying. Maybe walk instead.
Of course, it's your life after all, as you wish.
It's Mr. Scrooge. I give Mr. Scrooge the founder of the feast.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I'll give him a piece of my mind to feast upon, and hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
My dear, Christmas Eve. Huh?
It should be Christmas Eve. I'm sure the laundry is to have such an odious, stingy, hard, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know who he is, Robert. Nobody knows it better than you do. Would it?
I only know one thing of Christmas. One must be chosen here.
Fine. I'll drink to his health for your sake and the day's, but not for his. A Merry Christmas to him, and a Happy New Year. He'll be very merry and very happy, I have no doubt.
He cannot be happy, he must be happy for him. The song is good. Tim!
Shh! I just got him down and he's all the sleep he can get.
If he's asleep on Christmas Eve, I'll be much mistaken. Tim! My dear, there's nothing else that'll make him well.
Yes, Father?
You awake?
Just a little.
Song then.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, all. Ah, oh, thank you. Here's some money for your troubles. Who could that be at this time on Christmas Day?
Father Christmas.
Father Christmas doesn't knock on doors. He's moved down chimneys when I was asleep.
Bob.
Hello, sir. How are you doing?
I've come to bring you a feast. Presents for the kids. And for you, Bob. I've tripled your salary for the year. Merry Christmas. God bless us all.
Well, thank you, sir.
And ever afterward, it was always said of Ebenezer Scrooge that he knew how to keep Christmas and keep it well. If any man alive possessed the knowledge, may that truly be said of us and all of us. So, as Tannington observed,
thank you. Thank you. decided to name it Scrooge. I know that some of the film versions have been named Scrooge. And on the other side of that, we had quite a lot of talent, obviously, as you've already seen, that we wanted to show. So we decided to do Scrooge versus Santa, Santa versus Scrooge. That's what came with the name. So I am now what we call a gap filler. There is a big costume change going on at the minute. I'm sure you will enjoy the next act, but while they get changed, I'm going to play you a song called Grown Up Christmas.
yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. From now on, our troubles will be miles away, and may all your Christmases be
castles of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chiming, jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
For my own, more than you could ever. massive amount of hard work into the last few days, but weeks and months before that as well. So it's been a great triumph tonight, everybody. So well done. Okay, and don't be late in the morning.
No breath.